sometimes we're talking about legislation, a lot of things are coming out of state health and human service departments that are literally just mandates that go into effect that because the government has put a panel in place, right? And we don't even look at the intricacies of what those things are. So I think it's twofold. I think we have to look up.
Okay, so just to wrap up here, you're not a Trump supporter.
No.
So who's your candidate?
If I were to vote today, I would vote. I think I like Elizabeth Warren. You know, here's what I really think. If it was Warren Harris, it sounds like a white guy. So I think that if you just Warren Harris, it sounds like a white guy. So let's go for it. It can be a tagline. Let's go for it, right? So I think anything's possible. And I think that I say, yeah. I mean, she just made a whole butt ton of money from small dollar donors.
What was your take on the Biden-Harris exchange?
You know, it's interesting. Joe Biden, when I look at what America is and what I'm hearing from on the ground, it's just time for Joe Biden to be an elder statesman. Go buy your business, Joe. Why don't you just be a really great entrepreneur?
It's only true that people like change. I know that somebody's going to come here and clean up, you know, the swamp.
Yeah.
Shake things up. That's what got Donald Trump elected. Biden doesn't seem like the natural guy.
Right. And I think the straddling of experience and new ideas and living in a world that is transforming at this point, right? I mean, in the past 10 years, I'm a progressive person who is a very diverse friend. The way that we're talking about gender, the way that people are identifying, all of those things, you have to be in a lived experience on some level to really be able to hold what's important and what people face.
That's what I was asking, because in this campaign, the Democratic primary campaign, you've got four women running,
four senators.
You got two top tier with Warren and Harris. You got Amy Klobuchar. You got Kirsten Gillibrand. Tulsi Gabbard. There you go.
Then you
there's
have
five.
The woo woo machine.
Huh?
Marianne Williams.
Right.
I'll bet we can get her on some. Big part of that plan.
I mean,
after she listens,
there's always funny people who want
to
be the leader. Look, somebody who says, you know what's wrong with the world, I'm not in charge, there's a bit of an ego there that is always going to be playful and always have room for humor, no matter if you like the person or not, because it's just a bizarre thing to want to do, be in charge of everything. Like, no, like, it's weird. It's a weird quality, and yet it's the one you need to elect somebody, right?
Well, is there
All right, well, listen, this has been a great talk.
I learned something.
I didn't know that you invented fake news.
I invented fake news.
So we can now blame you for this plague
on
society.
And I'm dating Assad. You want to just...
Yeah.
show.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks to independent investigator and journalist Kuchita Sardoff and co-creator of the Daily Show, Liz Winston, for joining us on this episode of Skullduggery. Don't forget to subscribe to Skullduggery on Apple Podcasts or wherever you listen to your podcasts. And tell us what you think. Leave a review. The latest episode is also on
Sirius. Pass out.